All right. What's going on, everyone? Smitty here. Had to exit and come back in here real quickly. But I am about to get into this stream here. I'm going to get down on all Madden this time, see how this works out.
Receivers looking to make big plays on the field. It's Green's Bengals going up against Tate's Lions. With that, it's time to hook up with our commentators in the booth as we turn it over to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, first opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Detroit Lions. Hello, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. As we get set here, Charles, we talk about wide receivers. You know, Larry mentioned it in the open, but that's a big spot to look at here in this one.
I think he identified it perfectly because these guys have such an impact on the game nowadays because they throw the ball more than ever. And whether they're throwing it short, medium, or long, can they snatch it out of the air and create even extra yardage with run after catch?
All right. Sorry, I just let people know I'm streaming right now. I apologize for the any delays.
Here's the punter, Sam Martin, now ready to get us started, and we are underway from Ford Field. That's fielded in the end zone.
I'm playing this one on all Madden, so you know, for those that may, you know, whenever you tune in or whatever, if you know anyone does tune in. Just putting this out there.
TCU, it's Andy Dole.
This is a young man who has a lot of quiet confidence in his abilities.
Yo, what up, AZ? But if you ever talk to got done doing a great show.
In fact, I asked
once again. Always awesome when everybody, you know, interact with everybody. It's always a good look. And always appreciate it.
Former Tar Heel, Giovanni Bernard. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32.
So I'm thinking of doing here is while I'm playing, doing a little bit of testing here. Because while, you know, this is on all Madden, and I understand Detroit Lions do not have the greatest line ever. But, you know, when we play Madden, the feeling that we always have is that when it comes, especially when it comes to run plays, that it's always, you know, there's always an issue with getting that push into the backfield unless you come with the blitz.
Dalton throwing on second down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete.
Oh, man. In terms of the league, man. It's gonna be work in progress. It's gonna be work in progress, AZ.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for lost yardage.
It is gonna be work in progress for sure.
This is 3rd and 7. So 3rd and 7 and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
Here's Dalton. And Eifert has it. Mm. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And
for Eifert, man, the cat. I'm definitely going to have to mess with some sliders, man. Like, but you guys see the movement in the pocket. You know what I mean? You see the movement pocket-wise. And see their coverage-wise. Like, we, our secondary is not that good. You know what I mean? So using the Lions to an extent, it's going to look like, you know, oh, man, like, they don't do anything. They can't execute. I'm like, yeah, that's part of their problem. They do execute at times, but they need to do a lot more than what they are currently doing.
On 1st and 10, here's Andy Dalton to the left side here for Iowa.
See? He gone, man. He got that.
For a Cincinnati score. Tyler Eifert, 48 yards, and the Bengals are going to take a first quarter lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to
each and every time. A lot of people.
And
see,
let's see here. Want to take a look and see what it was that happened for him to get that touchdown. See, that was it right there. When I came with the blitz, you saw it. And see, this is the interactivity right here I'm talking about. And I know other people bring this up too. When they interact, like, I want to see these guys battling. Like, keep on battling. But here, that was it right there. The whiff tackle was what did it right there. And then he takes it in for 6. But I'll tell you what I'm going to do is this. Now, playing on all Madden, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the pass block and I'm going to drop that down to about, I'm going to put this at 0. I'm going to put the run blocking down to about 10. Oh, no. Do about 15. And catching, I put that about like 45. I want to see what kind of, since they, well, I'll have the ball next, but I'm playing it on all Madden, and that's the thing about it, is putting it on all Madden. Like, what I'll do is I'm gonna leave it like this at first. Oh, whoops, hold on, one more thing I want to adjust as well. I'm gonna drop that QB accuracy to 15 as well. See what happens with it being that low. If it makes an impact or not, we'll see.
And when all else fails, not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. And he's got it to make it 7-0 Bengals. After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line.
All right.
So here are the Lions now coming out for their opening drive. They'll be led out by a former Pro Bowl quarterback out of the University of Georgia, Matthew Stafford.
Matthew Stafford is a big arm guy who's learned how to temper some of his throws, actually has added a lot more touch and accuracy as his career has gone along. Big time confidence in his arm, though. Any throw you want, he can make it.
Let's see here. Good to see Madden going in the right direction. Yes, it certainly is.
Now here's the first carry for Amir Abdullah. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
It most definitely is. And thanks for coming through, was it Gerald? Thanks for coming through, man. Appreciate it. My dude AZ in here with me as well, you know, hanging out. That's always welcome. But
and after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
Let's see. Oh wow.
Here's Stafford now on second down. It's complete to go.
There we go.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line.
All righty.
So here we go. First and
see
10
what
now.
I can do here.
Stafford gives to Abdullah, and he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage.
See, once again, playing on, you know, all Madden difficulty.
When you play against Carlos Dunlop, you have to think protecting.
There's some things that I'm gonna adjust that'll be favorable for the user because of the way they
looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Like because of the way they play. Oh, I think I got something right here.
On second down, here's Stafford. The completion good. This is Eric Ebron.
They're not used to these Xbox controls.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some
But no, I'm sorry. I'm using the play calling, select play calling or the suggested play calling. Just for the sake of, like I said, time, you know, like when I usually do, like, because of time constraint. Now, one thing that is strategic, and I saw this on OS, and I've been playing my CFMs and everything like this for a mighty long time, like my offline ones in particular, is that I'll use the play call suggestions based upon their game plan.
Signing Bolden in July could be a huge boost.
Going along with signing Mark.
Hold on. I'm going to try it out. I'm pretty sure I'm just messing myself up. I'm asking for it, but I will not put it down to zero, but I'll put it at 20. Run blocking. I'll try it at 35. All right. I mean, I don't think that's really good for me playing it on all Madden. But yeah, it right, especially since my O-line isn't necessarily the best.
And his veteran presence can really help those young receivers.
Let's see what we got here. Yeah, he brought that blitz. Came through with the blitz. They got me.
So the Lions go backwards there, and unfortunately that's something they saw a lot in 2015. They had the fewest rushing yards of any team in the NFL.
As one of those dubious titles that no one really wants to claim. Even teams just say, well, I don't worry about running it because we throw it all the time.
Yeah, you don't like the passing, Cam AZ. I don't know. It's not too bad, but I can understand why it's not light.
To throw on second down to Stafford. Complete here to the right to Bolden. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because
right,
he might wander into some tough coverage.
And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third. From the gun on third down, Stafford. And that's caught. Did he stay in bounds, though? He did not. Ruled incomplete. A third down, he tried to stay.
That's something that I don't like here. You know what I'm saying? And well, let me go to the instant replay. It's something I don't like. And I mean, this isn't just a Madden. You know, this has been going on for a minute. This right here. Throws the ball. Like, he runs the route. He runs the route. It's clear as day over there. I would love it to have these guys have that awareness of what's of where they are. And so that way when that ball is delivered, you know, he turns it upfield instead of just acting like momentum is just taking him, like, unnecessarily. He's running toward the sideline like there's a defender on his hip. You see what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. So,
and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know,
I don't like that, because I should have been able to catch that in stride, take that upfield for possibly six.
The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, but the net gain, 3 points.
And you're going to have drives like that in this
league. Right.
Sometimes you just got to take the 3 and move on. Always better than nothing.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Try to get one more in here.
I'm not
going to
pay attention to all this play calling. No, I'm going to go into the deep book myself, and see, this is why I gotta go in the lab. See,
now at the end of 1-7-3 the score. We're back to the Motor City after this. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Alongside, like, Charles, look, Davis, I'm gonna go back to that last replay. Now this right here, don't like this, you know, the motion shift, him being shifted in like that. Do not like that. But then now we got more, you see what I'm saying? Like, now that, this I don't like from 77 though. What happened here? It was like, you know what I mean? Like, he was trying to take both guys on here. That didn't work out well. See these guys, they fight off their respective blocks and two guys get held up. So
Bengals with the football to begin quarter number two. Right. They've got it 2nd and 10 to start things out.
Alright.
Another look for Dalton on 2nd and 10. Out to the flat. That's complete to his quarterback. It's a loss of 4. Now 3rd down. The pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really,
and you see what I'm saying? You see all that time he had in the pocket? Like, I'm trying to reduce it to a realistic extent. Like, I just don't want to see guys just shooting into the backfield, you know, with it being on 0. You know what I'm saying? But then once again, the game does get this internal boost because it's all Madden. So I'll tell you what I'm gonna do for the next drive. Oh, see, look at that, pass blocking at 0, and look what they're able to do. So alright, so we'll see what transpires. Alrighty.
So on fourth down, on comes the left-footed punter, Kevin Huber, to punt it away. Back deep for the Lions, it's Golden Tate. Now it's Tate. Legs still churning.
Like a giant pinball.
Sheds a second.
Ooh, look at him. Cheesing our people. Is playing online better this year? People cheesing the aggressive catch. Well, if you call the proper play calls on defense, you will not have to worry about the aggressive catch being cheesed. Especially if, yeah, like, the aggressive catch is not the exact same mechanic as before.
But they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Here's Stafford. He goes underneath to Abdullah. It's a four-yard pickup, and it'll make it second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
6 yards to go here on second down.
Yeah, but as far as online, that I cannot say. I haven't played any online games yet, so.
On second down, here's Stafford. Ebron caught left side.
Dang it.
And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
And he gets it to Bolden. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. All right.
So you see, I don't have, you know, days on end to just be sitting back there in the pocket chilling. You know what I mean? If I'm going to make a move, I need to hurry up and make it. If that's how it's treated. Oh.
Woo. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away. But it does get away and it's second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass.
Oh, you only have an hour left. Oh, okay.
Not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Oh, no, I didn't want to.
On the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Geno Atkins was back and fully healthy in 2015. And when he's like that, he is hard to move.
Had a nice tackle for loss there. 17 of those last year, which was sick among all D tackles.
And following in the footsteps of his dad, Gene Atkins, a former NFL defensive.
That play worked out real well.
Just certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Right.
Trying to make some with the curls here.
Join us from Orlando with our halftime report, but business to take care of before that. Stafford to the right side to Eric Ebron, and he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll bring up second down.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays. Makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Here's Stafford now on second down. Caught right side, Tate. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense...
Well, since you logged in like nearly the 10-hour demo, what do you think about the game?
When you watch it on the screen, but everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one...
Can't wait to see what they do with Matt Mansch.
But I like the discipline.
You and me both on that one, fam. And then make the I can't wait. My dude Azura can't. Sim. Hey, everybody.
Play faked Abdullah. It's Stafford.
Oh, come on, man. Shoot. See, you guys see as I'm doing these pass situations, like it's not coming up as, you know, routine pass and catch or anything like that. Like, there's legitimate struggle going on here trying to make things happen.
Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. The Bengals with two extra
best man in a long time.
Nickel look on third.
Plank it in the passing lanes.
To throw is Stafford. That's caught at the three.
All right.
And now the Bengal defense here calling a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And for the second time this half, on comes the field goal unit here. From the right hash here, should be an easy one. And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
The Lions defense marching back onto the field now. And despite being down on the scoreboard, this unit, they've had some big-time hits.
Sort of like us at practice the other day. I saw you take a running start at that blocking sled. You took it down.
Bounced off like a rubber band.
No, not at all. But you're exactly right. They are doing their job, but they want to add takeaways to it. You need to have more of those to go along with the big hits we're seeing.
By the way, when I tried that and I bounced back, I noticed that you laughed with everyone else. You didn't try to get in my corner.
No. Someone had just told me a joke on the other side. Right, I missed that. Totally missed it.
Dalton, first and 10. Surveying the field. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. The Lions move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. All right, partner, while we have a second, a lot of people want to talk rookie quarterbacks early on. What have you seen?
The usual. They're going to be ups and downs. Jared Goff with the Rams, Carson Wentz with the Eagles. Both of them a little bit
open shaky. NBA fixes a lot of issues, too. Yeah.
Connor Cook,
I hope so, too.
But how about Trevon Boykin in Seattle? He was phenomenal coming back in and leading them to a victory.
And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Well, they get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down. Fakes the give to Bernard. Dalton. And Tate's got it. And he's brought down after a good gain. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23.
A really nice read by the offense. They caught the defense not covering the middle of the field. Went to the post route and found the receiver wide open for a nice gain.
Now Dalton with a first and 10. He's got time. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. They come up in an offset eye. Dalton gives to Bernard. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. 9 yards on the gain there, and it's going to bring up a tough 3rd and 7. And now on 3rd down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. The visiting, so this guy's just sitting there, right? He's got like 30 hot dogs in front of him. And what's that?
Let's see.
Apparently, we're NBA
game
so
issues. Yeah. And the thing is, there are some guys that do talk. You know what I'm saying? Just not that many.
Well, the return here comes Amir Abdullah. Then he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Now it's Stafford. Ebron with it over the middle.
And there we go. Up near the 35. That's it. A lot of dink and dunking going to be going on. You know? Now, I'm not playing with any, you know, I haven't done anything as far as, like, doing a custom, you know, having a custom playbook or a go-to list of plays that I like to use or what have you.
They'll run here. Abdullah. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was. His defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
Stand. There we go. 3-yard line. Let's go. Stick them deep.
Take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then,
Giovanni Bernard, nothing but green grass. The 30, past the 20. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score.
You serious right now?
Bernard,
man.
97
yards. Oh, man.
Third time in NFL history we've had a run of exactly.
Hold on. Yeah, oh, man, does feel like it does have that tendency. Yeah, nah, he had it locked up. Now, let me see what happens when I put that run blocking down a light. We'll put it at 5.
97 yards into the end zone. So we're witnessing a little bit of history right there, partner.
And what makes it that much more impressive for me is that if you're on defense, you're expecting them to run the ball. They're on their own 3-yard line. Not many people risking throwing it. So you expect them to do exactly what they did, yet it still breaks for 97 yards. That's a long way.
And some quick research. The other two, 2014 Lamar Miller, the other
I know the other one. Okay. That was 1939. Andy Urim. I was there. Oh, no, I wasn't.
You weren't there. You were almost there. You were a baby at that point. Yeah, 1939. Hmm. Wow.
Automatic first down.
So out now come the Lions, and they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you
shake
things up? You look at what you've called.
Come
before.
On.
You realize it hasn't worked
go to
so
something
well.
Else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going
yeah.
in the excitement area.
And Charles driving over to this one. Some intrigue around a few quarterback battles going on right now in the league, isn't there?
Cleveland, they settled in early August. San Francisco, Denver, those continue to rage. But how about the Rams returning to L.A. and bring a quarterback battle with them?
That one intended for Anquan Boldin. And it'll be 3rd and 10.
It looked like they
Anquan Boldin,
there,
okay.
Think that he was thinking about running with the football before he actually hauled it in.
Dropping a lot of them passes.
So here we go.
But
now
he did get hit, so.
Now Stafford. And he finds one that's intercepted. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six for a Bengals TD.
I hit the wrong icon, man. Oh, man.
Anything that you would think is just great strategy. It's just that when you have five defensive backs on the field and an
See. And you saw that there? Yeah, I'll go into the instant replay. And like always, see, like I said before, you know, we point out the good, the bad, ugly, all the above. We point it all out here. Now, look, if anything, this should have been an incomplete, not a straight up, you're going to let him get the catch. And this is why I need them to remove. I need them to move from that. You know, you got the receiver that's doing one action. You got the DB that's performing another, and the ball by itself. All three entities separate. Because then, like you see here, what's going on. So.
Tougher to complete a pass, and on that play, they completed it just to the wrong team, and it cost them 6 points.
It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-6.
Threw it to the wrong dang on icon. I was looking at one person. I was looking at one icon, but I pressed a different button. So, nevertheless, that is all on me.
And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now. Coming off his pick six. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Michael Johnson, he's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of 9. Looking to jam.
Getting popped with the sack. Excuse me.
Again, we'll see the right. Pistol here. Here's Stafford now on second down. It's brought in left side.
There we go.
It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that's going to lead to a third down.
10-yard pickup. Yeah. I don't know. That is part of it, though. For me, especially. Like, the console that I'm more accustomed to playing it on is on PS4. So then, but I hit the wrong button, though, nevertheless, though. You know what I mean?
Throwing on third down, Stafford. It's caught, Jones, and he will have first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that first down pass.
Yeah, it does, because I see the X and it automatically makes me think about hitting A.
Down at Stafford. A dump off for Abdullah. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
I know most of the time
see,
the ball's in the air.
Once again, that momentum. You know what I mean? Like having him carried all the way out of bounds like that.
I'm ready now for second and 9. Another pistol look here. To the air again, Stafford. And there's a flag on the field. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Holding. Defense.
Defensive holding. Oh, bet.
So the grab there by the defense, the holding penalty call.
Good look. Good look on the hookup. Well, I wouldn't necessarily say hookup. Let me see. It won't mean a darn thing if I can't make anything happen.
Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
See, and here we go. This is something. Ain't got me. Got me again. But nevertheless, this is what. This right here. Got to get cleaned up altogether right here. This animation likes it. You know, I'm okay with him getting beat. But see here, I've caught it back. I'm about to throw it, and then they make him just tuck it under. I'd rather it come out of his hands and be a wobbly duck here, or, you know, he just throws it down toward the ground and it's an incomplete, or the ball just squirts out and it's a fumble. But in all of that, I'd rather have happen instead of, the, you know, just having that scripted sequence play out and the play end that way. So,
the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long.
Let's see.
On second down, here's Stafford. To the right side to Eric Ebron. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a third and 11 situation.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
From the gun on third down, Stafford. And that one goes incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. Fourth down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Here's Sam Martin now. On for his second punt, he'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer.
Dang it.
And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Partner, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball. But how about them just taking it? Big time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established this run game, the play action pass could very well be open.
And he'll be out of bounds at the 25-yard line. Yards left for the offense. It's second down.
Let me see if I can.
Dalton throwing on second down. Over the middle, complete
to
Tate.
Man.
And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Oh, man.
Back now at Ford Field. It's the Bengals in possession of the football and in possession of the lead as well as we start the fourth. Second and five. Second down, Dalton. Green with a catch left side.
This dude got Mr. Got Mr. Reliable over there. You know what I'm saying?
In the NFL, because they can do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
Here's Bernard, and that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13.
All righty.
They'll run again with Bernard. And he's going
to
be stopped.
He tried to make some kind of... Let me try and make some kind of difference.
Third and 10.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. Third down, a shot here for Dalton.
Good D.
Contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And now a high kick, but he hit it straight up. Just a 30-yard punt that time. And out will come the offense as they take over. And Detroit getting set to go now. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him. All right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But so, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
There we go.
The play clock's running down. On first down, Stafford here. This is a screen to Abdullah. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Call it a gain of 5, and it'll be a second down. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Time running out here on the play clock. To throw on second down is Stafford. Looking for
what?
It's intercepted.
No freaking way.
It's a pick six for a
OMG. Alright, man. Yo, you know what?
Chances to make a team.
I'm done.
People using 5 defensive back, 6 defensive back packages.
Hold on a sec. Now look at this. Madden 16. At this point, I'm good throwing that curl. But here, it's thrown. He digs in. And he got in front of that.
Exclusively, but way more than before. That was a nickel package there. And what a pickoff.
Why is that? Why are they using that more?
Because more people are throwing the ball on earlier downs than ever before. This has become a passing league. And because of that, more defensive backs on the field on most plays.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot right now as this one's in the air. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 yards with a new rule as he's taken down right at the 20-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now.
Let's see. All right.
First down at Stafford. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete.
Just a 1 yard pickup on the play. It's 1 yard. All that work. Only got 1 yard.
We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old.
Man, 69 would have been six for me. Yeah, possibly would have been six for me.
Here's Stafford now on second down. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Throwing on third down, Stafford. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. Well, I'm definitely going to punt it.
He's on for Detroit. Here's Jones. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And the Bengals take possession. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Start on the ground here with Bernard. And for
here we go.
A few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere.
Yeah, I know. He basically didn't slice up. Okay, there we go.
So yeah. What will they do on the ground?
I'm like, no, I used to,
Time for a break.
I was too scared to get hit. Yeah, I like this game here. Whew. This is why, once again, I got to get in the lab and really, you know, play this and go through, you know, go through my personnel, like, I gotta go through my personnel, see, you know, where everybody's strengths and weaknesses are, and build up.
The distinction too, because the good defensive ends, they can do it all. Set the edge in the run game, make sure that no one can move it that way, and of course rush the passer. On that play, use the speed to get there in the run game.
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. Val Bernard.
There we go.
To the 29-yard line, brought down there. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down. Here's Kevin Huber now, as he's on to punt for Cincinnati. On the return, it's Tate. A nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. So here come the Lions now. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Well, that's what's up then.
Now a first down throw, Stafford.
Oh man. So you see, and you've seen how over the course of the game here, you've seen how these passes are getting dropped as they're getting hit. So they're not just automatically sticking to their hands.
Second and 10, Stafford again. Over the middle, complete to Tate. And the play goes for 19
yards. Yeah, I might as well just.
Gives him a new set of downs. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout.
I'll try to do something.
It's just their first. All right. Two more years here in the final stages. Throwing a Stafford. Another reception made over the middle. This is Bolden. It's a pickup of 19.
No, now all this stuff is happening.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
All right.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
This is possibly, more than likely, the last play.
On first down, Stafford here. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And he'll get this one down to about the 20
yard line. Well, money on every football game. Yeah. Slants are money in every game to some degree. You know,
that's
they all
the
24 are.
Hour rule comes into play, win or lose for all teams. Either enjoy the win for 24 or reflect on the loss for 24, then put it aside.
That's it.
Forward.
I got my tail kicked. 28-6. You saw me throw picks and everything. You see me mess up. Hey, and I, like I said, learning curve. Got to get my butt in that practice, on that practice field, and get to work. Learn this game. You know what I'm saying? And then, of course, the symbol will go forward from there. So, but all right, y'all. This is Smitty. Thanks for coming by. And this stream will be posted up on YouTube as well. So it'll be there as well. All right.
Charles Davis and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Ford Field.
All right. Okay. So those are the stats. And yeah, like I said, guys, you know, appreciate all you guys. Anybody, you know, any and everyone that came through. Greatly appreciate it. Like I said, I'll be streaming tomorrow as well. So I'll be streaming tomorrow as well as just all weekend as well. I'll definitely be doing some streams, talking about the game, all that good stuff. All right. So until the next time, everybody, be easy. Take care. Peace.